Hey, this is Presh Talwalkar. Alice is looking at Bob, and Bob is looking at Charlie. Alice is married, and Charlie is unmarried. Is a married person looking at an unmarried person? Yes, no, or cannot be determined. Surveys have found that 80% of people get this problem wrong. While you're thinking about it, I'm going to present a similar problem. A drawer has 10 black socks and 10 white socks. With your eyes closed, you draw 3 socks. Are you holding a matching pair of socks? Yes, no, or cannot be determined. Give these problems a try, and when you're ready, keep watching the video for the solution. Many people think the answer to the first problem is C, cannot be determined. However, we need to work through the logical possibilities. Bob is either married or not married. While we do not know Bob's marital status, we should work out each case to see if the condition is met. One case is that Bob is married. In that case, he is a married person who's looking at Charlie, who is unmarried. So if Bob is married, the condition that a married person is looking at an unmarried person is true. What would happen if Bob is not married? In that case, Alice, who's married, is looking at Bob, who is unmarried. So in this case too, there would be true that a married person is looking at an unmarried person. So the correct answer choice is A, yes. Although we don't know which married person is looking at an unmarried person, we know that some married person is looking at an unmarried person. Now let's tackle the next problem. Imagine that we draw the 3 socks in order. Now it could be the case that the first 2 socks you pull are both black or they're both white. In that case, you would already have a matching pair of socks before you even pulled the 3rd sock. Now what would happen if that's not the case? Well, then the first 2 socks would have to be different colors. You would have to have 1 white and 1 black sock. Then, when you pull the 3rd sock, it would have to be either a white sock matching the white sock you already have, or a black sock matching the black sock you already have. The 3rd sock must match one of the socks you already have. Therefore, in either case, you will always be holding a matching pair of socks. Did you figure out these problems? Thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel. I make videos on math and game theory. You can catch me on my blog, Mind Your Decisions, which you can follow on Facebook, Google Plus, and Patreon. You can catch me on social media at Presh Talwalkar. And if you like this video, please check out my books. There are links in the video description.